I experience sleep paralysis. I wake up in the middle of the night, paralyzed, and see stuff in my room. Sometimes it's shadows. Sometimes it's some demon creature. I hear voices and smell things such as sulfur or rot. I've woken to what felt like 1,000 spiders running over my skin, or with the feeling that someone was laying in the bed beside me, even though I slept alone. They're very terrifying moments, and I'm unlucky enough to deal with it all the time, usually when I'm stressed. But 2 nights ago, it was completely different. To start off, my 2-bedroom apartment is on the 2nd floor, and in an old building. The living room is in the center, with the stairs down behind it. And on the right is a small hall that leads to the bathroom and the 2 bedrooms, one of which is my office area. Many nights I see someone in the doorway to my bedroom just standing there and watching me while I can't move. I see it even when the door is closed. Your brain can mess with you pretty hard. The only thing that I found to help is to close my eyes and slow my breathing, which usually causes me to fall back asleep and wake up fine. 2 nights ago, that didn't work. Something felt different about the thing standing in my hallway. It was a tall silhouette, the size of the doorway. It moved twice while I stared, once into the office and once into the living room, and then it returned back to my doorway. I had never seen something so large before, and could feel a panic attack coming on. I couldn't move for what felt like hours, and when it returned to my doorway, I felt sick. I could smell something strange in the room, soot and coal mixed together. I knew its gaze raked over me, and the few places that had slipped from under the sheet. It started to chuckle, a chilling sound that echoed in the quiet. I wanted to yell, to do something, but by the time I could move and see the world as it was, it had moved on. I called my boyfriend and whined until he came over. The doorbell rang a little after 3 in the morning, and I rushed down the steps to answer the door. Luke stood on the other side and yawned, eyes half glazed over. Our conversation is me going off memories, so it's as close as I can remember. I can't wait until we move into the same apartment. I was having a good dream, babe. You ruined that. You so owe me. I grabbed him and pulled him into a tight hug. He stood shocked for a moment and then put his arms around me. You really freaked me out this time. I nodded into his shoulder. Thanks for coming. Yeah, of course. Come on, let's head up. He moved me back to the door, but I didn't let go until we were against the steps. I moved my hand down to his arm and gripped it tightly as he closed the door and locked it. He led the way upstairs and moved to the couch where he made me sit. I'll make us some tea and you can tell me what happened. You don't have to, I started to say, but he placed a finger on my lips and shushed me. Tea, and then we can talk. No arguing. You dragged me over here in the middle of the night, so I call the shots. I gave a huff and crossed my arms as he left for the kitchen. He came back out after putting water in the microwave and sat down next to me. Alright, so what happened? I rubbed my arms and shrugged. I don't know, it's stupid. Come on, Cassie, it's not stupid, just tell me. I saw something in my doorway. Okay, but you've had that happen before. Why so freaked this time? It was different, I said, and I took a sip of the tea and nearly burned my lip. I just felt different, and I couldn't go back to sleep. Well, let's take a look around just to be sure everything's good, he said and got up. I followed him with my eyes as he went to the hallway and looked into the bedroom. He stood there for a moment without a word and then came out, a strange look on his face. Cassie? What? What's wrong? I put the tea down on the coffee table and could feel my hand shaking. He looked toward the other bedroom, his brows knitted together. Were you drunk with charcoal or something before you went to bed? I shook my head, confused. I was an artistic type. I got up and came over. I don't have any charcoal here. Okay, can you explain this? He moved aside and held a hand out to the upper wall beside the door in the bedroom. There on the white paint was what looked like a smudge of an upside-down cross drawn in charcoal. He reached up and ran his fingers through it, and then rubbed it between his thumb and finger. Feels like soot? How the hell would you know what soot feels like? I spent the summer with my uncle a few years ago. He made me clean out the fireplace and chimney. I'll never forget the feeling of it. He tried on a smile, but faltered. So this wasn't you? No, what the hell's going on, Luke? I could feel my heart thudding against my ribs. This didn't feel right, not at all. I shivered even though the apartment was warm. Where the hell would Suit be coming from? Luke shrugged. I don't know, you could have touched it outside or something. This place is old. And I drew a damn cross by accident? Don't jump all over me, I'm trying to figure this out too, he said as I tangled my hands up in my hair and walked away. What exactly did you see? Just this tall silhouette in my doorway. Most of the time they slender and they don't stay at the doorway, but come into my room and stand over me. This one just watched me and I could feel it stare. Like, I don't know, like it was feeling me up with its eyes. And that never happened before? No, and it moved around my apartment, which never happened either. Where did it go?
I pointed at the office room in the living room.
Just entered both of the rooms and then came back and watched me for what felt like forever, chuckling at me. Then it went into the office and I could get up again. When I looked, nothing was there.
Luke went into the living room. I heard him move a chair from the dining area and then called me out.
There's another one here.
I went over and in the corner near the AC vent was another smudged upside down cross. This one much smaller than the other. Luke was on the chair looking into the vent.
What the hell is going on here?
Luke looked angry after a moment, his hands balling into fists.
This is the first time you saw this silhouette?
I guess, they kind of merged together after a while. He stalked out of the living room and into the office.
Luke?
He didn't answer me as he went into the office and started moving the boxes around. I was in the middle of packing as we had found an apartment together.
Luke, you're scaring me.
Son of a...
What? What is it?
He shoved aside a bunch of boxes so he could get to the wall, where a square of wood went around a piece of the dry wall. He pulled on the top and a whole section of the wall popped out. Inside was an old brick fireplace. Luke started to curse as he stuck his head inside and looked up, and then down. He slammed his hand against the wall and left a soot print on it.
You're coming with me, he said as he got up. He came over and grabbed my arm. Get some clothes and let's go.
Wait, you gotta tell me what's going on.
That wasn't just sleep paralysis. At least not completely, he said, and he pulled me into the bedroom and turned on the light. Get some clothes.
He then went over to the AC vent and cursed.
Another damn one here.
Wait, what the hell do they mean?
Get the damn clothes.
He went back out to the hall and looked up at the wall. I went about getting clothes into a bag, and then met him in the living room.
Will you just tell me what's going on? You obviously know something.
He came over to me, his eyes still on the AC vents, and pulled me to the stairs and then down them. We got to his car and he opened my side and I got in. He dropped into the driver's seat and puffed out a breath. He just sat there for a moment and then dug for his cell phone in his pocket.
Who the hell are you calling?
The police, he said as he started his car and turned on the headlights.
What? Why?
He held up a finger as someone must have picked up.
Yes, I need the police down here. Someone was in my girlfriend's apartment and I think it was her downstairs neighbor. Yes, I'll stay on the line.
He gave them my address and then looked over at me. I couldn't breathe and my mouth was dry. He reached out and rubbed my shoulder.
It's gonna be alright.
The police arrived about 20 minutes later. Luke went out to speak to them and then came back for my key to the apartment. They went up and looked around, and then the police pounded on the apartment door below me. No one answered. Luke and one of the officers came back to the car, where I sat still trying to wrap my head around what was going on.
You have your rental office number?
Luke asked as he opened the door. I handed him my cell phone and he found it, and gave the number to the officer. He then sat down in the driver's seat.
They're gonna try to get into the apartment.
I smacked his shoulder and he looked over at me, surprised.
Why are you not telling me anything?
He cocked his head and then shrugged.
Sorry, I kind of freaked out.
You're freaked out? What about me?
What's going on?
He turned to me as much as he could in the car.
That wasn't your imagination. Someone was in your apartment.
I felt sick and shook my head.
No, that doesn't make sense. I made sure the door was locked. I didn't have any windows open.
No, whoever it was came through the chimney. The marks of soot was them trying to clean up after themselves. Luke sighed and looked out the window shield.
Someone was in your vents, and I think they knew you were moving out soon, and didn't want whatever it was to be found.
I stared wide-eyed.
What do you mean? What would be in the vents?
He shrugged.
Cameras is my guess.
He swallowed hard. Look, I know this is uncomfortable, but during your sleep paralysis, did any of the shadows or silhouettes do anything to you?
My breath caught. There were times when I felt like the silhouettes were feeling me up, rubbing my chest and stuff, but I chalked it up to just normal pressure that most people feel during sleep paralysis. Now I wasn't so sure.
This makes no sense.
We'll know more once the police talk to them. This could be just me overthinking it.
BS, I said, and hoped he was just overthinking it.
Of course he wasn't. The police got into the downstairs apartment and found a bunch of computers and electronic equipment. Apparently, there were cameras all over my apartment at one point, filming me. Filming us. Filming the silhouette touching me in my bed while I slept. Now there are a bunch of videos of me nude in some nerd cop's computer who was using it to look for evidence, and they still don't have the guy. Although they're fairly sure the guy was uploading the videos to, I think they call it the dark web or some other stupid name. So yeah, it's out there on the net now. The guy must have gotten spooked or something and disappeared. I'm staying at Luke's place until our leases are up and we can move into a place together. Somewhere without fireplaces.